Hello YouTube, I was thinking about doing this video for a long time. I hope to make it short. I'm just gonna show you the different types of sharpening and what do you call them, the terminology. I'm just wetting my dressing stone. Dragging off the edge, so I start with a dull blade there. That is de-stressing the apex or cutting off the apex. The apex is basically the cutting edge here. Now it's dull. I've dragged it off, so it won't cut my finger. This will be the same if you use diamond plates or whetstones or Japanese whetstones or oil stones. I'm using my PDT diamond plate, M25. So, terminology. First off, the edge, that's the same as the apex. And that's dull as you see. When I'm sharpening the edge bevel, I'm sharpening the very edge. When I set the bevel, that means the angle, if it's for example 20, 10, etc. And if I'm hitting the edge, I'm sharpening the edge bevel. If I want to create a multi-bevel, for example, let's say a tin at 10 until I hit the edge, then that's the main bevel. If I raise it at say 20 and do a few strokes just to make the edge a little tougher, that's a micro bevel, and that should look just like a hair on the edge. And now the complicated, if you are doing behind that, behind here, you are thinning the knife. That means removing material, so it basically gets thinner behind here. So it keeps it thinnest down here, so it doesn't get as thick as up here. Also, if now of course it's butter knife dull, but if I haven't dragged off the edge, let's say this has a beautiful, scary sharp edge. A touch-up is just literally doing 2, 3, 4 swipes per side, maintaining the edge. That's a touch-up. A full sharpening is removing the edge and creating a one new again. A reprofiling means you are altering the edge angle. Let's say it's 20 original, then you are maybe going down to 15, then you are reprofiling the knife. If you are thinning it, you are removing metal from behind the knife. I'm gonna start thinning it a little. Again on my M25. Again. Let's say I'm sharpening here, just for fun, thinning is here, it's basically flat, and just lifting so the spine doesn't touch. And again, I'm not using any pressure at all nearly. Maybe 200-300 grams. Just removing metal behind the edge. That will make a knife cut much easier. And I mean much easier, because if it's thinner, it slides through stuff easier than a thicker one. It will also help, it keeps its edge longer. and make it easier to make a new edge, since you need to remove less material to create a new edge. As you see, the core scratch pattern. And a little more up here. And you can see by the scratch pattern, that's the scratches in the knife, where we need to go and sharpen. There, changing. I don't have that much space here, so trying to utilize it as good as I can. And I've changed the way the camera angles. I hope this is better. Doing the same thing on the other side, barely having the spine off the stone or diamond plate. And again, this is thinning. I'm over near the edge or apex, and not making it sharper or reaching a burr here. I'm sharpening behind the edge, making it thinner. So you can't feel the burr here. If you can that, you're doing something very wrong, or you basically have a paper thin knife. Not gonna thin much, this is just a demonstration. Now I'm gonna create the main bevel, the main edge. Of course there isn't any burr, it's still blunt, as you can see I'm not cutting myself. Creating a new edge bevel, I'm gonna go at around 12 total. That means around 5-6 per side. Per side means the angle here, let's say, is 5 degrees. 5 degrees per side is 10 degrees total. So if you see a knife that got, says, 30 total edge angle, that's 15 per side. I'm doing here maybe 5 or 6 per side, so 10 to 12 total. I like my knives pretty thin, and I'm gonna micro bevel it at around 15. So now I'm creating the main bevel until a burr at around 5 to 6 per side. And again, I'm sharpening to a burr since I'm creating a bevel now. And I'm gonna do the micro bevel at around 15 per side. I'm using no pressure here, basically 100 grams maybe. Just the weight of the knife. Checking. Reach the burr yet, since I'm taking it so damn low and thin. I also dragged off the apex, so this is gonna take a bit longer time. Just leave a comment if you wonder about anything. I would love it if you please press like on the video, please share my videos, subscribe to my channel, of course that helps a lot. not reach the burr, but I'm gonna flip sides. Because sometimes when you go as low as that, the edge can basically bend. So I'm just flipping sides to make sure the edge is uniform. If it takes too long, I'm not bothering about lowering the edge angle so much, so I'm just gonna do it at 15. I just thought I would show you the point of what the difference between the primary bevel and the micro bevel is. But I'm not gonna spend much time on this, so. The micro bevel should always be done at your finest stone. If you create your edge at 1000 and I got a 5000, do the micro bevel on that. Because it should be as slim and small as possible. Flipping sides again. This is just to ensure the edge is straight. I'm not bent. And then all 5-6 per side is crazy low for this Victorinox. That's why I'm snapping on a micro bevel on it. We're over yet, 12 minutes. Got the burr at the heel, that's that part. Not the belly. And not the point, but I'm nearing there. So, let's go a little more. And a burr is when it feels basically like you haven't shaved for a couple of days and you run your fingers on your skin. It should be smooth and then feels like you catch on something, like it tingles in your fingers. And this would be faster with a coarser stone, of course. It's pretty decent quick, this diamond plate. Just me that wants a very, very, very low angle. Let's see. Got a burr at the tip. At the heel, but not the mid part. Because that's the place that sees most use when dragging off the edge. That's the point that is most in contact with the dressing stone also, so it makes sense. Using the entire diamond plate, so it wears even. They wear incredibly slow this. Doing some full strokes just to make sure the edge is even. There I got a pretty good burr. Flipping, doing the same time on the other side. Let's see.
Is that too much?
Yeah. Just repositioned my stone holder. Doing some full strokes just to make sure it's uniform. And one side often forms faster than the other. Just bear that.
How many minutes are we at?
16. And it takes a little time when reprofiling a knife, creating a new edge bevel. If this was a touch-up, it would literally take 20-30 seconds from start to finish. But I'm starting from scratch here. And you can touch up a knife 5-10 times before maybe needing a full sharpening like this. So yeah. There, got the burr. I'm gonna flip to my finer plate. This is a M25. I think it's around 600-800 ish grit. It feels more like 1000 after some use. When it was fresh off the sandpaper, it felt like a 400-600. Just putting it back. And then going to the M6.3, if you can see that. Let's see, where is the burr? That side. There. Now doing very light pressure. Again, just now doing very light pressure. Basically just the knife. This is called deburring. Just flipping sides, weakening the burr. And I'm at, I raised a little, so I'm maybe at 10 per side instead of 5 to 6, just to get that started. Since it took too long being at 5 to do 6. Doing some full strokes. Just stropping. Stropping means going away from the edge, and I'm doing this on this dowel. I'm gonna check the edge if it's sharp enough before I put on the micro bevel. Just checking if I've established a good edge. Magazine paper. It's a very sharp edge. It's a little job at the tip. But now I'm raising the angle ever so slightly, going up to 15. Just touching it up. Doing a few strokes, just the weight of the knife. Nothing heavier. there, again stopping on the towel. And when you start to sharpen, or any time at all, actually it doesn't need to be perfect. It needs to cut food good. It doesn't need to cut magazine paper perfect if it cuts food good. It's food you're cutting, not paper, but I like to test on this. That's a very sharp edge. So,
I've tinned it. Then put a primary bevel at around 10 degrees. Then a micro bevel at around 15. So, again, please press like. Please share the video. And subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.